Dog Lake is one of Ontario's best-kept walleye secrets. It's far enough south for a long growing season producing big walleyes, but still located in a very remote region of northern Ontario. And as a result, walleye fishing pressure is low and the walleye population of Dog Lake is high.
There's so many times that techniques makes a big difference. You could be in the same boat and you have three people.
Yes.
And nobody catches anything and you're hammering them.
Yeah. Presentation and color. Sometimes the fish tone right in on color. A lot of times it's, if you're using artificials, I find it's more the action, you know?
Yeah.
Texture and stuff. Get their attention.
Oh, here we go.
Come on. Uh-oh. I'm just going to be net boy today, eh? I'm net boy. How's it feel, Ward?
That feels decent.
Walleye?
Yep.
Attaboy. I'll come on this side of you here.
I'll get out of the way here for you.
Hey, you're on camera, man. Welcome to the Warren Show. Nice one. Feel good?
Yeah, decent.
Oh, yeah. Just one of the smaller eaters, eh?
Yeah.
Like if you wanted to keep fish, that's the deal, right?
Yeah.
We'll let these guys go just for...
It's got a nice color to them.
Beautiful.
We have walleye here that are blue.
Yeah, well, I caught one blue walleye early this week. Never caught one before. But I do like these traditional ones, eh? Nice something.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Look at the colors.
Color
just beautiful
on that
fish,
is.
Man. Wow. Nice. Let me touch it. I know what walleye feel like here.
Yeah. So, that one there is about 16 and a quarter.
You got them up this side, up this way too, eh?
Yeah.
It doesn't matter where you're casting, you just catch them all around the boat. So you just follow them around like a cat. Everywhere you cast, I cast back that way. But one more fish, I'm going to pink.
I think I heard that already.
Yes, that's true. But I just got bumped back there.
Yeah.
I'm used to using the chartreuse, oranges, purples and stuff like that. So thinking I'm being a smart guy, using my hot colors like clown or orange and chartreuse, well, caught one bass and a small walleye. What happens is the owner of the lodge who says, use pink, I use this. Now he's kicking my butt, nice bass and a bunch of walleyes. You see how fast I changed to pink? What would you say is a peak time to come here for walleyes, Warren?
Generally, June's our prime time. Generally, and then last week of July really starts to pick up again and goes throughout, you know, into September. We've had a couple of guys fishing in October, but they're just guys up there that are moose hunting, so they're just kind of killing time midday, not really hitting prime time. They do good too, but normally it's, for me, it's time to start shutting things down, so I'm in the water.
There we go. Look at that pink. Do you believe that, hey? I'm a believer now. And doesn't feel too bad. Just an advertised walleye, eh? Look at that, on the pink, right away. I believed you before, and now I'm convinced. Pink is it. Maybe they like lipstick.
Yeah.
Hey? Little Eaton-sized walleye, but we're going to let him go. We're going to try to get some big ones. Ready, walleye? Ready? Go on, boy. See ya. He doesn't know what was up. All that effort to come out here to catch me, kiss me, and let me go. Hey, we want to catch some big ones. Feel that rod bend. Let's see if we can get some big Dog Lake walleyes. Here's my choice for the rod. 6'6" St. Croix Icon, made for walleye fishing, with a 3/8 ounce jig, 8 pound fluorocarbon, small spinning reel, as easy gets. You know, you get those fish fighting chance, but then you can feel them fight and stuff like that, but there's nothing interrupting, no swivels, no leaders, nothing, just you and the walleye. You can't go wrong with quality craftsmanship. You know, they're priced right, but again, you can feel the fish, they got enough backbone to set hook. Yeah, pretty sure that's walleye. Are you walleye? You're eating size walleye? You feel like you are. Oh, he probably is again. Oh, yeah.
Want the net?
No, I think it's good. I mean, like, those are the ones. Oh, yeah, man. You know, Warren, if I was a hungry man, I could eat three of these and I'd be done, right? That's six fillets. Like, how many do you really need for a meal, right?
Yeah.
Like, when people think those 20 inchers, no, man. That's the ones you want to eat right there.
Yeah.
Look at the back on it. Nice, thick fillets. You know, you have the right license. You're allowed to keep three like this and one over 18 if you want. But, I mean, it's those 14 to 15, 16 inch, man, there's a lot of meat on there. And, you know, you want to keep conserving these awesome fisheries. So there is trophies and there is the ones you can eat and stuff, because when you put these lodges, yeah, the fishing is paramount. But boy, there's so much more involved. Come up with your buddies, you're having fun. You know, it's just sitting back, relaxing, shooting the breeze in the lodge and stuff, playing pool and darts and whatever it is, man. It's a vacation. But catching fish is so important. Conserve for the future, and they'll always be here for you, him, and me, but mostly for you. Let's put it back out. Let's catch some more.